So tell me, where are you scared of the dark? When it all goes down and the lights go out, I'm not the one you wanna see. Some will and some won't, some do and some don't. Now tell me who you're gonna be. See, I couldn't really give a fuck if I am so unbearable. All that I really care about is that I'm uncomparable. They're bigger than me and they're quicker than me, but they know that nobody is sicker than me, cause they can kill X and they can kill Y.
Hello, welcome, Devil Sniper here, season number 5, episode number 2, and we are in the semi-final of the European Championship. But before we go into that, look at the top goal scorers. Filippo, Isco, unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable. We're even looking at players like Destro, who are in the top goal scorers. You know, it's amazing. Nelson Oliveira, Jack Wilshere is there. It's brilliant to see not only West Ham players at the top of these charts, but players that we are targeting. Big, big players in the world of football. You know, the likes of Insigne, the likes of De Jong, the likes of Destro, leading the assists in a top tournament. And they're the calibre of player that we have to bring to West Ham, which is unbelievable. It's just such a great feeling to be able to think about adding such world-class players to our team, which I say with great confidence is a world-class team, an absolutely fantastic team. And as you can see, Joe Hart, 2 clean sheets to Butland's 0 clean sheets, which is very interesting. But like many tournaments, players who play well, their prices go through the roof. And I'm going to be heading off, hopefully, the price increase by making inquiries to see how much the clubs at this current point want for their players. Hopefully, it won't be too much because, as you know, we only do have a really limited budget, which was 25 million given to us by McVitie's. But on top of that, we have sold Nathaniel Clyne. And the money we get from Nathaniel Clyne should hopefully give us around about 30-ish million pounds, give or take, to do business with, which we are going to be doing a lot of business with. We have to make a good few changes. We'll be looking to add up front. We'll be looking to add at the back, right back, centre back, in the middle of the park, and also up front. That's the positions we're looking at. Regardless of the amount of quality we're bringing through from the youth team, we have many positions to add to and strengthen our squad, because we can't sit on our laurels. We can't just sit back and think, well, we've won the Capital One Cup, the FA Cup, the Premier League and the Champions Cup. We've got to progress and get better and better and better. But anyway, it's time to focus on the game ahead. We are the away side, but we're playing against France in the semi-final of the European Championships. And we're going up against a world-class side. Ribéry, Benzema, Ben Arthur, Pogba, Envilia, Clichy, Lloris. And on the bench, they've got Nasri and Remy. It's days like this that you've worked so hard for throughout your career. These are the days that you cherish and look forward to and long for. You're playing in a semi-final of the European Championships. You know in your heart you are 90 minutes, maybe 120 minutes away from one of the biggest games of your life, the European Cup final, which would just be absolutely immense. Absolutely immense. I can't believe I've been so lucky not only to manage West Ham but to be given the England job and have such a fantastic side to work with. It's just been a great pleasure. Hopefully I will do the nation and the fans justice and give them great pride to say they are English. We pick the game up with Wilshere in the centre of the park, feeding the ball back into Josh. Josh knocks it into Theo. Theo knocks it into Jack Wilshere. Jack Wilshere knocks the ball onto Oxlade-Chamberlain. Chamberlain back into Josh, and England are playing a beautiful football early doors. The ball's fed into Jack Wilshere. Wilshere into Rooney. Rooney trying to create some space for himself and plays a sloppy ball, which is picked up by Clichy. Clichy knocks it into Ribéry. Ribéry into Paul Pogba. Pogba is going down the left-hand side, cuts back inside, knocks the ball into Ribéry. Ribéry spots that Tompkins is out of position, cuts inside, knocks the ball into Villa. Villa knocks it back to Ribéry, but Kolker is there to stop France progressing forward. Gives the ball to Tompkins and he clears it. France with a great corner, swung in. Great defensive play there, but Gibbs gives the ball away and disaster strikes. 15 minutes gone, France take a surprise lead. Kieran Gibbs again with sloppy defending from a corner, giving away a simple goal. He should have just put his foot through it and just launched it into row Z, but unfortunately tried to play the ball out, which is fantastic to see, but it costs you goals and we can't afford to do that. Wayne Rooney moving forward on the right-hand side. He feeds it back into Theo Walcott. Walcott knocks the ball into centre of the park into Josh. Josh shakes the shoot, goes for the shot, but it's blocked. Theo Walcott picks the ball up. He has to turn back at himself. He gives it to Rooney. Rooney goes for a shot. It comes to Welbeck, and Welbeck slotted it home after 34 minutes. Unbelievable luck there for England. Rooney went for the shot. It looked like it'd take a strange deflection. And Welbeck pounced. It looked like it hit the post and went in as the goalkeeper. Absolutely great play. Walcott with a great ball into Rooney. Rooney's shot was deflected. It looked like Danny Welbeck got a little bit on it, but it hit the post and in off the goalkeeper. But I don't think England will be bothered about that. And again, France are immediately back on the attack. Great ball in, but Tompkins with good assertive defending and an easy ball for Butland to look after. And we join it with Wazza moving forward. He feeds it into Theo Walcott. Walcott into Chamberlain. Chamberlain pulls the trigger and that's a great save by Lloris in the French goal. Absolutely huge save. Josh with the corner swings it in. And Welbeck's there. 45 minutes gone and Danny Welbeck not only doubles his goal tally, but he scores their second for England with an absolutely audacious header. The movement of Danny Welbeck at that corner was purely world class. He loses his defender, he drops back, dives in front of him and gets a simple header home to give England a 2-1 half-time lead. And the fans are absolutely in dreamland. Can England hold on? Will England hold on and go to the final? Pogba has the ball in the centre of the park. He knocks it forward to Benzema. Benzema feeds the ball out to Ribéry on the left-hand side, being marked by Nathaniel Clyne. But he gets away from Clyne. He's getting away from Tompkins. The ball comes out to Kat Pon and a great shot onto the post. Looked like Butland got a hand to it as well, but England are going to make some much-needed substitutions. They're being stretched in this second half. France are totally dominating the game with possession, outplaying England in all aspects of the park. Cheverley comes on to shore up for Walcott. Ashley Young for Oxlade-Chamberlain, and we're taking off one of the forwards and bringing on Daniels to hopefully make a big change in an influence. Sloppy defending there, but England are lucky to get the ball away. The ball's with Danny Welbeck, and he clears it, thankfully. But Ashley Young in the centre of the park gives the ball away sloppily, and Ben Arthur pounces. He feeds the ball into Ribéry. Ribéry into Nasri. Nasri puts the ball in. Tompkins has it. But that's a sloppy clearance by Tompkins. It falls to Nasri. Nasri slots it across the box. And Ribéry slots the ball home after 86 minutes. That's really poor defending by England. And the French have punished them with a very simple goal. Great play by Nasri. Not to take the shot, but to knock it across the six-yard box. Butland could be questioned. Should he have come out and taken that ball? Who knows? We'll have to ask him after the game. But England are on the back foot now. The French well and truly towels up in the air, thinking they can come and take this away from England. Gibbs on the left-hand side feeds the ball inside to Ashley Young. Ashley Young knocks it forward to Josh. Josh feeds it into Wayne Rooney. Rooney pulls the trigger. Great defending by the French. But Welbeck's there. He slotted it home. He looks across the line. The flag's not up. The goal will count. The goal will count. 88 minutes gone. Danny Welbeck has scored his hat-trick and given England a 3-2 lead. A great shot by Wayne Rooney. It was deflected by the defender sliding in. The ball fell to Danny Welbeck and Welbeck just slotted the ball home after 88 minutes to give England a 3-2 lead. Can they hold on for the next 5 minutes? Will they hold on and go to the European Cup final? This is absolutely dreamland at this moment in time. Nasri on the ball for France. He played it into Villa. Villa gave the ball away. And it comes to Josh. Josh has the ball in the centre of the park. Looks inside. Plays a very sloppy ball. And Ben Arthur picks the ball up for France. He knocks out to the right-hand side with Benzema. Benzema back into Ben Arthur. Ben Arthur into Nasri. Nasri into Ribéry. That's a huge save by the England goalkeeper. And Josh manages to clear the ball up the field. And the referee blows the final whistle. It is unbelievable to comprehend. England are in the European Championships finals. Unbelievable what a season it really has been. Not only for player, not only for country, but for myself as the manager. And we have the opportunity of playing Germany or Filippo and his Italian squad, which would include Destro. How amazing that would be to meet Filippo in the final of the actual European Championships. That doesn't even beg thinking about. So we have some inquiries. Montoya, Barcelona are looking at £10 million. Spurs refuse to come back to us on Kyle Walker. Destro is a bid in the region of £25.5 million. That is an absolute huge chunk of change. Nelson Oliveira is £13 million, which is quite an acceptable fee when you think we only paid £12.5 million or £12 million for John Guidetti. Obviously, Stuttgart came back and said they won't be buying Diarmi, which is good because I really didn't want to sell Diarmi. Rodrigo has a price tag of £25 million, which is just absolutely a huge amount of money. I can't even comprehend it, to be quite frank. James Tompkins, we've received an offer for him, and to be honest, I am going to be letting Tompkins go. I am going to let him go. If we can get the right amount of money, I think it's time for him to move on and for us to look to bring in a slightly younger centre-back in. But I just want to try a different centre-back. Tompkins has been an immaculate servant to the club. He has been a fantastic player. But if Chelsea agree that price tag, then quite frankly, I will take it all day long. And as you can see, we get £12.5 million from the Nathaniel Clyne deal to Juventus. And Blackburn have accepted £1.6 million for Hall. It's a sad day to see Hall go, but at the end of the day, I don't want him just sitting on the bench playing reserve team football when we have the likes of Rocker coming through. It's just it's imperative they get games, and they're just absolutely amazing players. On top of this, we have some more offers coming in. I am going to let Stacey go. Unfortunately, it's been a bit of a tough time for him. He hasn't been able to break into the team, hasn't been able to make an impact, and I'm going to have to let him go. Gabs, on the other hand, I'm not willing to let go. He is 29, but I know no team's going to pay the sort of money we're looking for, so I'm quite happy to put in a counter offer, just in case. You know, it's only fair to Gabs to give him the opportunity to think about moving on, but I know for a fact he does not want to move on. Now, this one came as a bit of a surprise. I was speaking to the Paris Saint-Germain director, and he said that he wasn't going to come in for Butland, and he's gone against his word. He came in with an audacious £28.5 million offer. That's not how much Butland is worth. This is how much Butland is worth, and not a penny less. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you for the final.